first down. Wins. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. 19 yards right off the bat. And a quick first down. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. So second and 9, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Wentz going to throw. Out to the left here to Reed. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Wentz going to try and throw on third. This is Johnson, he's got it. And hello, he's going to be knocked backward. As he'll be marked down. That one goes for 29 yards on third down. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Into the red zone. Wins. And that'll be incomplete.
Oof. That one didn't quite make it to the target, but that's not always a function of the strength of the arm of the quarterback, is it? Sometimes there's just too much pressure there. In any case, the ball doesn't arrive.
And on second and 10 now. Wins to throw again. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. And they'll let the fullback try and take him home. And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. It's the fullback taking it in from 2 yards out. And the 49ers drive right down the field and score on the opening drive. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This is fielded at the goal line. They find some open field here. And he's going to be out of bounds across the 50. Great return.
Well, you gave up the first touchdown of the game, but how about the response? Big time return. Now it's their chance to try and put points on the board.
Just beating the play clock is gone. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. First first carry for Marshawn Lynch. Oh, he's got a little daylight.
Jesus.
And all the way in for
this
the touchdown.
Be a very rough game.
Marshawn Lynch, 41 yards.
Because you can pancake 90s, I guess.
Away from tying this thing up. And on that long run, 90s maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This is taken at the three. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Touchdown. LaDainian Tomlinson, 78 yards. And the 49ers have now taken the lead.
God damn it.
And his kick is no good. It's an early miss. We'll see if that has any ramifications later here as the afternoon wears on. Sturgis out now to kick this one off. This fielded at the two. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Oh, for
fuck's sake. And now he'll
let
this one go deep. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
You know you should have been down right there.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. First down, the run with Lynch. Broke through some contact, but unable to reach the 40. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it. Those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
And that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a fourth down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
And an alley to run!
Yeah, you better fucking do that, jackass.
A good decision in the end to pull it and run, get some 9 yards at a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Seated to my right, Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Toronto football to begin quarter number two. And they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. First down. Here's the run with Peterson. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll bring up a second and 11. They run again with Peterson, and he struggles to get a yard here, maybe a yard, down to the 31.
The best defensive lineman
They play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands that can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop.
Bullshit.
The defensive tackle position.
Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
We'll go with that.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Now gone. And this one complete to Reed. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well.
And he is into the end zone for a touchdown. Marshawn Lynch with his second touchdown here in this first half.
Oh, going to come down to me and shank
it.
His guys
are an extra point away now from taking the lead. And they will line up now for the two-point try. Out of the gun. Gone. And this will be caught.
Yeah, fuck you.
For two. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
The 49ers offense now, they work their way back onto the field. Four minutes to play here in quarter number two. And they'll run with LT to begin the drive. He'll be tackled shy of the 35. Shifty footwork gets him a little extra on the play. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. To throw on second down. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. And he's brought down. 11 more on that one and another first down. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes you'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Tomlinson again, a first down carry. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
Well, with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
Now wins.
Oh, I gave that one to you.
Picked off by Jalen Ramsey, the 30. Touchdown.
Well, partner, I do know this. If you're a defensive back, you have more chances to make a team now than ever because people are using five defensive back, six defensive back packages. Not exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there, and what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league, and because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This fielded at the two. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Oh, he can't hang on. That was a dream chance for any D lineman to possibly get a pick. But instead, it falls down incomplete. And now we're circling here around the two-minute warning.
This is a setup play, trying to get one last one in before the clock warning.
Back to the air on second down. Wins. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The target that time, Michael Thomas. And it's third down.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Game clock at 2:01. Time for one final play before the two-minute warning. Time running out here on the play clock. Throwing his wins. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, C.J. Mosley. And they will...